Well, here I am on peg 119 on Syndicate Lake today, and the reason I've chosen this peg is to show you a method and a bait that I have talked about a bit in the past, and this is fishing worms in the margin. We're coming into the time of year where the margin pegs aren't necessarily where you want to be. The temperature's dropping, the weather's getting definitely colder, and the fish will tend to edge away from the edge pegs, the island pegs, and in particular, the corner pegs. However, you could still draw one. And this is where worms can get you the best out of these pegs in these situations. There's a big head of big perch, roach, tench, and hopefully a handful of carp to really bump the weight up. If I were to come to this peg and fish baits like corn, meat, and even pellets, that would be very selective. And what I'm going to show you today, hopefully, is how I go about putting a bag of, like I say, these better perch, maybe some roach, maybe even a tench, and hopefully some carp. And that is with the aid of the worms. I'm going to be feeding hemp, casters, corn, and a little bit of chop worm, and looking to fish half a worm or even a whole worm on the hook, and put together double figures of bits and pieces, and hopefully in amongst or towards the end of the session, a handful of carp to really bump the weight up. In a lot of commercial venues, it really is a good way of fishing and maximising the most out of pegs like this. I don't expect to catch a massive weight here today, but what I'm looking to do is to go away afterwards thinking to myself I've caught the most out of that peg that I possibly could without being too selective. I'm going to show you the rigs now. Again, quite simple, the rigs. The two that I've assembled today are on puller kits with grey hydro. There is a few branches along the bank, but they shouldn't be a problem. So I've come down because these fish may well run into the deeper water because it's a bit colder. The line is 018 straight through to a size 14 gamma carp and a small bulk. And again, the float, like you know, is a favourite of mine, KC Carper Rock, and like I say, direct to grey hydro. Again, fitted with a puller kit. The rigs are quite simple. The feeding's going to be in the big pot, half a pot at a time. Again, looking to catch one or two fish, hopefully some carp at a time, and then wait and see. I'm not looking to feed often. I'm not looking to feed a bucket load of bait. Again, this time of year, less bait. Feeding less often should give you a few chances. Another thing I want to talk about briefly is the peg itself. You can see that there's a few branches in that. And first thing this morning when we arrived, I actually went over and pulled a couple of branches out that were going to be in my way. Whatever you do when you get to these margin pegs, corner pegs, or even island pegs, don't be afraid to actually clear the bank a little bit where you're going to fish. Try and clear any obstructions, overhanging branches, anything, as this is definitely going to make your day a lot easier. And in my opinion, it won't spook the fish. Like I say, today, I do expect it to be hard. Hopefully hook some carp later on in the session. So what you do first thing when you get your peg, i.e. removing an odd branch, won't be detrimental to your day. I'm now going to feed and see if we can start putting a few fish together. There we go, there's the first carp of the day after about 40 minutes of fishing. But the most important thing about the session so far is we've probably caught 3 to 4 pounds of decent perch. And I hadn't hooked any carp. And then it went quiet for about 5 minutes, the float went under, and we were rewarded with a carp. And the power of the worms isn't just catching fish like this. It's at the end of the match, it's the weight of other fish that you've got. Well, we're into the session now. We've had one carp, which for this early on in the session, under these conditions, I'm quite pleased with. But the main thing is that we've put together a mixed bag of other fish. We've had two bream, two or three big roach, and a number of decent perch. I just want to talk to you about the way I'm striking. because I'm fishing with worms, I'm fishing probably about 3 inches over depth, just to give myself a little bit more stability in the rig. With corn and meat, you can fish dead depth because the bait's a lot heavier. With worm, I just like to fish that little bit over depth. And because of that, I'm striking straight up and reasonably hard. Because of the grey hydroelastic, if I do hook the smaller fish, I've got a fair bit of give and can play them and get them in. Like I say, we're into the session now. We might only have one carp. Hopefully we'll hook some more. But this is where worms comes into its own, is that we've got already well in excess of double figures of silverfish, which is the point I was trying to get across at the start, that on these colder days when the corners aren't producing massive weights, by fishing with worms on the hook, you end up with a much bigger weight than if you purely just target carp with selective baits like meat, corn and pellet. You can see I've got another carp on here, and it just underlines the fact of the last topping up for carp. I just caught a carp. The conditions have changed a bit. I topped up with corn, hemp and casters for a carp, and I've hooked another carp. And it just goes to show that just by trying to read your peg and topping up accordingly, that it can pay off. You can see the grey hydroelastic there working perfectly. It's a real good choice. It's not, I used to use white a lot, and the fish have just grown a bit. And the good thing is, in this corner, there's no snags to pull the fish away from. You can see that's a lovely big common, probably close to double figures. And these corners, where there isn't anything to pull the fish away from, grey hydro, now the fish have grown, is starting to be my number one choice. As you all know, white hydro used to be, but the fish have just put on that little bit extra weight. You can see by this fish here, it's still fighting in the net. A lovely long common, probably about 9.5, 10 pound. But it really does bump the weight up. And like I say, just feeding accordingly, looking for what fish are going to come in when the weather changes. If it goes hot and flat, look to target the small fish. And then look to target the carp either late in the session or when the weather changes and you think it's going to be good. So again, I'm going to feed a little bit of hemp and casters and about a third of a pot of corn. That's the good thing with the grey hydro, is it is a little bit heavier than the white, obviously, but you can still catch these silverfish. And you've seen today in the first part of the session how important the silverfish are in match conditions, just trying to keep your weight ticking over. The last thing you want to do is sit there not catching anything at all before the carp arrive. If you've got the option of putting 10 or 15 pound of silverfish in your net first, you've got to take it, because at the end of the match it's going to be vitally important. As you know, we're using worms on the hook, and I tend to hook the worm when I'm fishing for big fish straight through the head and just nick the end off. The only other way I do hook the worm is to nick the head off, then put the hook in and then nick the bottom off. This is for when it's harder, just to get a little bit more juice out of the worm out of either end. But the reason I like to hook it straight through the head for big fish is, again, because of the head of the worm's pointed, and you can put the hook in, you leave a lot of the hook exposed, and the bait then is less likely to go back over the point, which, as we all know, results in fish being lost. Again, you might notice that I've virtually put all my eggs in one basket, one line, but what I've wanted to do is to be in the right place at the right time, catch the weight of silverfish, even perch this big, they'll all add up. And the good thing is with worm, you can see it's not damaged, so it's literally straight back out. It can be a very fast way of fishing. But going back to what I was saying, I've only targeted one area, and like I say, there's not going to be many carp caught now that the weather's on the change in pegs like this. So it's about being in the right place at the right time. I've caught the weight of silverfish, and in between we've caught 6 carp. And like I say, if I'd fed 2 or 3 different places, it's easy to be in the wrong place at the right time and not actually catch these carp. Whereas we've been getting bites regular, just feeding one spot. When a carp comes in, we've hooked it. And that's the biggest difference. If you can get bites by fishing one spot, then definitely do it, because it's easy then to be in the right place at the right time. If I'd have fed an edge line, a method line, or this line, or that line, like I say, I could easily have missed out on the odd carp coming into my swim. Well, we're coming towards the end of the session and it has really gone to plan. Just lately there's been a few more carp, a few less silverfish. Although the conditions haven't been perfect for carp, probably goes hand in hand with the fact that it's the time of year, the water's getting clearer, so you're not going to catch as many anyway. But what we have managed to do by using the worms as hook bait is to catch a reasonable weight of silverfish, as well as 7 or 8 decent carp. Another little bite there then. Just by coming away from the bank, again, the water's slightly clearer. We're getting into the time of year now where these kind of pegs aren't going to be the pegs that you're running to, but there's still a very good chance that you could draw them. And that's the reason we've come here today, to show you what sort of weight you can put together while you're waiting for the carp to appear. It's different in the summer if you draw a peg like this. The fish are going to be here and you're definitely going to catch a weight, even if it's late on in the match. This time of year, 60 to 80 pounds win in most matches. If you do it right in these pegs, you can still put that sort of weight together. It's about being not too selective, using baits that you're going to catch the carp on, yes, but you're going to put together a reasonable weight of other fish while you're waiting for the carp to come into your peg. Again, we've only fed one place, but like I said, by feeding one place, it's easy to be in the right place at the right time. If you get a double figure fish come in your swim, you want to be fishing where that fish is, not trying another line. So it's very important. If you can get bites just by fishing one line constantly, then it's definitely best to do it, because that way you'll definitely be in the right place at the right time. Well, we've come to the end of the session and there's a silverfish we've managed to catch. I'd have said between 16 and 18 pound, which when you think about it, at the end of the session with the carp is a good bonus. To catch these kind of fish when the carp aren't there, see a lovely roach there, even a rudd, the perch are a nice size, and we've even had a couple of decent sized skimmers. Like I say, it's a brilliant bonus to have with the carp at the end of the session. And when you're tackling these corners, especially this time of year, you're going to have a large period of the match where the carp aren't going to be there, and that's when you need to target fish like this. Let's have a look at the carp anyway. Well, there you go, there's the carp we've had. There's only 7, but 3 of them are definitely close to double figures. Probably about 50 to 55 pound, which with the silverfish wouldn't have been far off winning a match today. From a peg, I wouldn't really have picked. But it's a brilliant exercise to show you just how powerful worms are, not only to be fed, but as a hook bait on their own. Not only have we caught a decent weight of carp, but when the carp weren't there, we put together a decent weight of silverfish. And it just goes to show that if you get your tactics right, even in hard pegs this time of year, you can put together a winning bag of fish.